بها نفسا شغوفا للعبادة ساعيا تبغي سبيل ربها وبلهفة تتبع خطى وهناك طفل ينهد خلقا جميلا ويرتوي يخطو خطى نحو العلا يتبع أباه في خطى فالنقش في صدر الطفولة شابه نقش الحجر.
I've just entered into Masjid Al-Khayf. Masjid Al-Khayf is located within Mina, subhanAllah. Some even argue that the reason why Mina is so special is because of the presence of this very masjid. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when speaking about this amazing masjid, he said, "Salla fi Masjid Al-Khayf sab'un nabiyya," that in this masjid of Masjid Khayf, 70 prophets prayed here. To the point that Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu is narrated to have said, and uttered from him, is that he said that if I was living in Makkah, I would do all of my Jumu'ah prayers within this masjid, subhanAllah. Now Masjid Khayf is also believed to be the location where Ibrahim alayhi salam brought his dear beloved son Ismail alayhi salam for the sacrifice. And it makes me recall the beautiful passage within the Quran in Surah As-Safat in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فلما بلغ معه سعيا قال يا بني إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك فانظر ماذا ترى قال يا أبت تفعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين صدق الله العظيم سبحان الله. In which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of when his dear son Ismail alayhi salam, who was at a tender age of maybe 10 years old, if not just slightly older, he was able to walk with his father Ibrahim alayhi salam into the mountainsides. And Ibrahim alayhi salam turned to him and he said, "Oh my dear little son, I have seen in a dream that I am to sacrifice you. Fanzur madha tara. Tell me, what do you say about that? What do you think?" He said, "Ya abatif al ma tu'mar," subhanAllah. This young, beautiful child, Ismail alayhi salam, he said, "Oh my dear father, do what you've been ordered to do. God willing, you will find me from those who are patient." And then the ayah goes on to say, "Falamma aslama wa tallahu lil jabin." And when they both had submitted themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Ibrahim alayhi salam turned his son face down, he couldn't bear to see his son, his face, when he was to sacrifice him. "Wa nadaynuhu an ya Ibrahim." And then he heard a voice. Some say it was Jibreel alayhi salam himself saying, "Oh Abraham, Ibrahim alayhi salam, قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. You have fulfilled the vision. إِنَّكَ كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And likewise, this is how we reward the doers of good. إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْبَلَاءُ الْمُبِينَ. And subhanAllah, this indeed was a manifest test for Ibrahim alayhi salam. وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allahu Akbar. And this is why we sacrifice, brothers and sisters. Whilst walking through this beautiful masjid and enjoying being here, I've just come across a very important notice, a fatwa, a legal ruling by the local authorities here, subhanAllah, just to clarify the point that with regards to doing the Jumu'ah prayer in the Masha'ir mosques, the masajid in Mina and Muzdalifah is ruled invalid. So there cannot be a Jumu'ah prayer here or in Muzdalifah, because one of the conditions of that is that you are muqeem, that you're a resident of the place, as opposed to a traveler, a musafir.